And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives shifa. But the doctor is the zariya, is the way through which many a time the shifa is given. It is a good profession. But as I mentioned earlier, that the verse I quoted of the Quran of Surah Fusilla, chapter 41, verse 33, which says, Woman asked call me mandailallahi, Wamil Solihaun, call a Indian Muslim. Who is better in speech than one who invites to the way of their Lord, works righteousness, and says that I am a Muslim? When I have to treat the patient's illnesses, I have to get immense pleasure. But when I started treating the people spiritually, I got multiple times more pleasure. So I chose to be a medical doctor to serve humanity. But when I found a better profession, that treating a patient spiritually is far more superior than treating a patient medically, that doesn't mean being a doctor is something which is wrong. It's a very good profession. But the better profession is of a da'i. So the best profession as far as Akhirah is concerned, as well as this world is concerned, is conveying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to those people who are not aware of it. And here you have two options. That either you can be a part-time da'i and continue with the profession, like a doctor or engineer or a businessman, or you opt for being a full-time da'i and dedicating your full life towards that. Now, whatever profession you select, the point to be noted is you should see to it that you get the people closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you analyze the lifestyle of a beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the lifestyle of the Sahabas, again, what is the meaning of the word profession is very important. What do you mean by career? If you mean profession means a person who's spending his maximum time in that particular activity, that is the real definition. It doesn't mean what time you spend in earning a living. Most of the people think that what time you spend in earning a living is your profession. According to me, profession is where do you spend your maximum time in a day on average, besides the normal activity of sleeping, of eating, of offering salah, which is a fard on all the Muslims. Besides this, if you have 10 or 12 hours in a day, where do you spend your maximum time? So the maximum time that you spend according to me is your profession. So in this aspect, our beloved Prophet, though you are the businessman, but I feel that he's a da'i. You are the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a profession, you are the da'i. A person who spread the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's far superior than a da'i. And at the same time, he did business. So I would consider him being a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He spent his maximum time in conveying the message. And he was a part-time businessman. Similarly, most of the Sahabas, they did do business, they worked. But the major time that they used was in spreading the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For me, also alhamdulillah, I'm involved in many businesses. So that way I'm a businessman. I have many businesses. Though I don't give more than a day in a month on those businesses. All my business put together, I don't spend even a day in a month looking after those businesses. I have many. So like that, I'm a businessman. Fine, I'm a silent partner in the clinic and my brother is a 50% partner. So that way I am involved in the field of medicine also. But hardly, I don't even go once a year to the clinic, diagnostic center. But I spend most of my time in conveying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a full-time profession, I am a da'i.